Her name is Jenny. Her name is Yellow Elk Woman. And when she went into boarding school, they changed her name to Jenny Nelson. So these are all my relatives. He came out in the 1830s.
It's important to me to be a Native American leader in ministry because I'm already a Native American leader in my community. I'm very active in my community and I'm already a leader here. And I think it's got a lot to do with I'm called. That's all I can say. Urban Native American community in Phoenix has somewhere around 300,000 urban natives. And because we have 21 reservations in the state of Arizona, lots of natives come to Phoenix for jobs or to go to school or just to leave a bad situation on the reservation. They're looking for a better life. So because we opened our doors to people, we just had this influx of people that came in that we realized don't have Christian education, may not be Lutheran, may have been very hurt by the church before, but we're still seeking a place of community and family because as natives, we're very community and family oriented.
Our mission is to heal the ones who've been hurt by the church. That's our mission. And then to bring them back, to get them to understand that you weren't meant to be hurt in the church, that it's not hurtful. God loves you regardless.
I needed a different type of ministry, that one that would empower people. And as I sit in the energy of Jesus Christ, that's what Jesus did. He went out and empowered people and told them, you're going to do greater things. And that's what our people needed to hear.
My mom's leadership, my mom has really big shoes to fill. She is so well known and she knows so many people and she speaks so well and she's been doing this for so long. I just don't think that I'm ever going to be able to be the leader that she is or be able to fill those shoes, but I'm going to try really hard.
The ministry should not die because the preacher left. And that's how I feel about this ministry. If I'm gone, there's going to be many others that are going to carry it on. It's not the work of one person, it's the work of everybody. And Wanda's really good about spreading her wings and encompassing of the larger community.
I wasn't sure if she was gonna actually take that, leap and be like, okay, I'm gonna do this, But she talked about it and she mentioned it numerous times and she did it. And I'm like, yes, you're gonna do it. And I'm excited to move forward with her, to be honest. I really am.
When she told me she got the fund, she was crying, I cried, because we both knew our ministry couldn't afford to pay for her to go through the seminary and for her classes and airfare and all that. And I told her, Wanda, let's pray, God will take care of it. If it's meant to be, it's going to happen.
But I don't have synod or really church-wide support until that scholarship came along. And so until that actually happened and I saw what the program was and the value of it, I didn't have a big push. And that's kind of what pushed me to be like, okay, now you're really in it.
He blessed it. He gave it for all to drink, saying, my blood will be shed for you and for all of humanity. As often as you drink of this cup and eat of this bread, do this in the memory of me. The more leaders we can have, the better. And we could branch out. We could have different types of ministries if we had more trained leaders. And we can only do that through funding.
Years later down the road, if somebody's watching this and says, look, there's a Native American female that was identified that year, and look what she's done over the past however many years with the ELCA, I could be that person. And I'm really hoping that the person that does watch that is a Native American or another person of color that gets inspired by my story.